because it is the largest. So Patagotitan, it is the largest dinosaur family.
Original fossilized teeth, but not only from megalodons, but from a lot of other shark species, because the megalodon, as big as it may be, isn't the only animal living in the waters. Take a look at facial teeth. All of these individuals are in the ocean, such as dogs. This is a dog. It is cute, it's an open. It lacks the superior part, and that bone doesn't go in the brain, but it may also have a box with which they connect to the chocolate. So here we also have an example of success in the box of the sea, the ocean. So how come there are corals living in Patagonia here, animals typical from warm waters? Well, take a look at what was Patagonia like 60 million years ago. We had araucarias, we had white ferns, we also have lots of animals that don't live here nowadays. For example, the taxon that we see, that we saw in the first room, you have platypus over there, because they have found platypus fossils here in Patagonia, but nowadays they only live in Australia. That is actually an original fossil. It is a log that belonged to an araucaria around 45 million years ago. It is petrified, so it means that my
that has a name that means carnival bull because it has a pair of horns on the top of its head. It also had cartilage spines all over its body that is known because of the prints that is made on its skin. So all over the sky. There were two different rows. You have one on the right, one on the left, and between each of them there was skin, for example, that allowed them to move better, easier in front of the wind. So it just stay. They evolved towards some of the birds that we know nowadays. All right, that's why we have behind the reception the hall with the different kinds of fossils, and also we have in the center the replicas of the Unalakia, for example. That's a dinosaur, that's half dinosaur, half bird. Basically, it's a dinosaur with feathers. And then you have all of the free circle birds that are the last part of this huge evolutionary chain. Those are Latin names, so they don't actually have a translation. And they couldn't fly very high. They had very badly developed wings, so they didn't become extinct either, even though they fell a lot to the ground, because they would lay eggs every 72 hours, so they evolved towards the German sharks that we know nowadays very efficiently. There on the ground you have the Megarachne. It is an animal that was first thought of a member of the spider family. That's why its name, it means big spider, huge spider. But when they studied it thoroughly, they actually discovered that it was closer to a poisonous scorpion than to a spider. And those
if you keep on looking out to your right, you will see a kind of slant bridge a little bit. That takes you to an aluminum plant. The aluminum plant is the first source of income of this city. It was built in a... You'll see when we return this midday, you will see the snow, you will see the tide with coming up, will be coming in, and to realize the difference.
Big males are massive. Look at the size of them.